Have you ever met a contemporary genius from Russia? Or maybe you heard about them? I suppose not often. Another question. Do you know about guys from Silicon Valley? Most of them are guys from CIS countries who have found the way to express their ambitions and mad ideas. They have direct correlation with our lives. For example, Andrei Doronchev has created the YouTube app for iOS, which is used on each gadget in our contemporary world. How is this fact connected with my theme? Quite simple. Russians are the specific nation with its own advantages and disadvantages, but I swear there is a lot of smart students who have their smart, sophisticated things in their mind, facing a lot of artificial obstacles. Now I'm in the 9th grade, and even in my class there are some prominent students who are suffering from our system. But they have an inborn talent, and if you ask, can conventional Russian school generate a genius, it would be a rhetorical question. Russian educational programs have become outdated and don't keep up to adjust to our reality with precipitating turnover of changes and innovations. Soft skills such as communication, leadership, time management are excluded from studying process, and students don't able to use hard skills at school and further in the future at a real job. It's like having a car and know everything about complex construction without driving skills. Another acute problem for each school is underestimation and indifference to the students who speak their mind and try to attain a certain degree of success in different ways. The most popular phrase is, "Do you think you're the smartest here? Thus, sit back and be quiet." It may sound exaggerated, but it's impossible to put into words how complicated it is to argue with somebody who is older or has a higher status quo. Unfortunately, I faced with such situation last fall when a persistent effort to obtain the best marks in order to switch my educational profile from humanitarian to physical and mathematical one, as I was eligible for this privilege. I had sent two applications, but I was told that my target didn't make any sense, and it was better to stay in humanitarian class. Frankly speaking, I was frustrated, because I had the best results in my class, and I worked against the clock for 2 months before the application. Ultimately, after a lot of struggles, I was channeled to this class. However, it's not the end of the story, because as a result of this transition, I encountered with bullying from my classmates. They claimed that I was stupid without any proofs and unworthy to study with them under the impact of the teachers. I came to terms and continued to ignore them with a light heart. But is it known, it never ends but it pours. The next challenge was my English teacher at school, when she started to accuse me and underestimate my knowledge of the language without any evidence. When it comes to arguing with teachers, I will never make mountains out of molehills. Therefore, I try to substantiate and stay away from this dispute, but I had to resist. I have written an official letter of complaint with argumentation to a headmaster, which helped me to get appropriate marks finally. These two examples reflect how restricted your possibilities to develop, and it's only a drop in the ocean. After years of underestimation, unfair competition, bullying, and other difficulties, chasing a dream is becoming more and more far-fetched idea. And as a result, many students give up. Russian comprehensive school kills people of the future in all senses. Is it terrible? Absolutely. Are we obliged to transform the outdated system? Absolutely. Thus, let's take matters into our own hands. Only you can choose your future and facilitate possibilities and conditions, at least for the next generation, but maybe even for the whole world. In my view, the whole conception of education must be converted. Extracurriculars should be free as well as general education program, including tolerant attitude to everybody. However, there are some possible solutions to make young life a little bit easier now. The first is professional orientation. Many companies have already invented such system, which help you to figure out your strong sides. But simple test with questions doesn't explain how real life works. Instead of this, I would recommend to invite students in universities and allow them to attend real lessons. In addition, practice on real work, maybe even for free, will be useful to discover pros and cons of the job by yourself. The second is psychological mentoring. It's not a secret that being a teenager, it's not the best period of your life. Raging hormones don't allow you to control your emotions and make the best decisions, and especially choose the job for the whole future life. Moreover, it's quite complicated to have good relationships with the family. The expert would help to understand yourself and clear your minds. We can't deny the fact that nerds rule the world. For example, Elon Musk, who has made significant contribution in technical process, not only on our planet. Nevertheless, he also was suffering from bullying at school. If we change the attitude to studying and appreciate its importance, there would be a great amount of smart students who could transform their conception of human life. All things considered, it's sufficient to remember that even if you have insignificant results, it's better than nothing, because a little progress each day leads to incredible victories. And also, if you are not in your class, don't worry about others' opinion. For you, the sky is the limit. Don't prevent others from the growth. Continue to broaden your own horizons, and we would live in the flourish and magnificent world. Thank you.